South Orange is popping as the Pirates are putting Seton Hall back on the map. The men's basketball team is coming off one of the biggest wins in university history, but they have a lot more work to do against a grueling schedule. The women's team, on the other hand, is trying to find their spot as they try to prove their place too. Will the men continue their early season dominance? Will someone help out stars Lauren Park Lane and Andre Espinoza-Hunter? My panel and I will discuss all this and more. My name is Michael Stamm, and this is Hall Talk. Welcome back to Hall Talk. I'm now joined by my two amazing analysts, Louie Pasculli and Christian Gardner. Guys, it is an exciting time for Seton Hall. But first of all, how are you guys doing?
I'm doing good. I'm happy to be talking about Seton Hall basketball and maybe some volleyball. So this is going to be a very exciting show we have.
I mean, it's the best part of the year when basketball is back here at Seton Hall. So I could not be happier, Michael.
You know, what the best part is when Seton Hall is winning. And that's what they're doing this year. The Seton Hall Pirates men's basketball team is looking like a team with tournament goals. After a defeat against Ivy League favorite Yale, 80-44, they stomped into Michigan and completed one of the greatest upsets in Seton Hall history, taking down the number four team in the country. Louie, I'm going to start with you. Just what are your immediate takeaways from this last amazing week of Pirate basketball?
This team is for real. This is probably the best team we've seen since Miles Powell, and maybe even a little bit better than that Seton Hall basketball team. Oh, watching them play is so fun. They held Michigan to 65 points, excuse me, which I think is not being talked about enough, as that is a great defensive showing from the Pirates. But no one singular player has to carry this team in order to win games, and I am so here for that.
I mean, the depth of this team is amazing. I think on a Yale game on Sunday, I immediately hit the group chat as I was excited, as this team confirmed is going to be good. And they lived up to it, and then some on Tuesday, taking down Michigan on the road, down by 11. And Michael, Louie, that is the best win of Kevin Willis' career.
Yeah.
That is the statement win. And from 20 years from now, 32 years from now, we'll be talking about that win, as it was immaculate. The energy on this campus, I mean, South Orange is a neighborhood, yet nobody went to sleep by midnight that night. I mean, the amount of cheers that you could hear throughout all of South Orange. I was walking to campus to go visit WSOU on Hall Line, and just everyone's honking and having a great, great time, because that is not a run-of-the-mill win right there. That is not going to happen every single time. First in program history of non-conference top five win. That is not something to go by the wayside about. And this team, like you're saying, Louie, is for real.
Yeah, I have to completely agree. One of my favorite things that Kevin Willard said is when he was, you know, doing his press conference, when he was doing a couple interviews, he acted like this is what was expected from this university, from this team. And I really like that. He didn't act like he was surprised they won this game. He said himself, we expect to win these games every time we step onto the court. And that's what they did. Are we even talking about how important this Michigan game really is to the team? Or, like, how important for the rest of the season will this game matter?
I mean, it seems absurd to think about March here in November, but I mean, when it comes down to it, this is a team that was number one caliber, like a number one seed in March, and you're taking them down on their home court. I mean, for this Pirates resume, it is amazing, absolutely amazing. So can only push this season forward and shows how capable this team can be.
I agree. For resume purposes, it's fantastic. Like you said, also for chemistry and bonding purposes. Yeah. I mean, think about how good of a bonding experience it really is for this Pirates team to come out to really not have that much playing time with each other and win against a huge opponent on the road. Going forward, this win is going to help them so much more than just in the standings for the NCAA. It's going to help them also be better as a team and better as a whole. So this Michigan win has so many good upsides to it, and it's really, really awesome that they were able to go out and secure this victory.
Yeah, we're going to have to see on Monday when the rankings come out, if they are part of that, where they are, if they are a part of that. Obviously, huge win, undefeated, but there's always room for improvement, and you have a tough schedule coming up. You have Ohio State coming up. They're still a ranked team. You have Texas coming up. They're a ranked team. Obviously, Villanova, UConn are both ranked. What is one player right now that is standing out to you that you would probably like to see maybe a little more from?
Well, my player is T-Bone Tyree Samuel. There was a graphic up that said his nickname was T-Bone, and now I want to keep calling him that because I think that's an awesome nickname. He has played very well, so I don't really want to call on him to do any more, but I'm sure improvement would be much appreciated from the Seton Hall Pirates team. He's averaging 9.7 points and 7.3 rebounds thus far. He had a fantastic first game of the season when he came out with 11 rebounds and 19 points in the first game. He's a really impactful player, and he's also showing that he can play on both sides of the floor. He's really, really good both on the offensive and defensive side in grabbing rebounds as well as scoring points, so I think he's a really big piece of the Seton Hall, both offense and defense. But I also go back to the fact that he doesn't always have to produce for the team playing well. So he can have an off night and have that be perfectly fine, and the team still could get a win. But thus far, he's been playing really, really well, and I'm going to look to see if and or when he is going to continue to keep playing well.
I'm going to go with one of these key transfers. I mean, Kadari Richmond didn't have his top night against Michigan, but we know how long and the length that he has on defense, what he can add. But I really want to see him get more aggressive, go to the cup, and go get a bucket for himself. I think missed that a lot against Michigan. I think a lot of this offense was relying upon different threes, open shots that they could find. But down the stretch, it's about going to the cup, and I think Kadari Richmond could be that player for the Pirates.
Yeah, I definitely have to agree. Kadari Richmond, one of my favorite players coming into this season. I was really excited to see what he brings to this Pirates team. And you know, I think that we love Bryce Aiken. We all love Bryce Aiken here, and if he stays healthy, that's amazing, because then you have Kadari Richmond, that defensive piece, and if he can get even more aggressive, then you have that great starter in Richmond with Aiken bringing that offensive game off the bench. But like he has in the past, if Bryce Aiken does miss one or two games, you are going to want to see a little more from Kadari Richmond on the offensive side. That's something I'm definitely looking out for, too.
And Michael, if I could jump in about Bryce Aiken, I mean, I feel like for this time, while he's been for the Pirates, Michigan was one of his best performances.
Oh,
and
yeah.
Just want to take the time here on Hall Talk because I, myself, have not been a huge fan of Bryce Aiken and Jimmy Bliss, who's probably watching at home. I'm sorry. You were right. Bryce Aiken is that guy.
Bryce Aiken is that guy, confirmed. Looking at this Ohio State game coming up, another huge ranked game. Obviously, Ohio State not as highly ranked as Michigan. They've been in some closer games, but what are some things from the Pirates that you would like to see cleaned up as we go into this game?
Definitely on the offensive side for me. I think they were settling for a lot of threes. I want to see more from Jameer Harris as well. I mean, he's a lethal shooter down the stretch, could not buy those buckets so much, and more from Jared Roden, obviously coming off that injury. Definitely want to see more from him because we know how capable he can be.
And this is pretty specific, but I would really love to see them hit Aiko Biagio on the pick and roll. So many times throughout the game, he is pretty open. And now I know he's not the best offensive player, but nevertheless, if Seton Hall can find him on that pick and roll, he'll get towards the basket. He'll be able to draw fouls. That's, you know, points from the charity stripe is never a bad thing. And also increasing the other team's total fouls is never a bad thing either. I think they're going to have to look for him more on the pick and roll. And if they're able to do that, then I think their offense can excel to new heights.
Yeah, Ike Obiagu and Alexis Yetna, that partnership right now is just amazing defensively. They are doing a great job. Kevin Willard, every press conference, is hyping up Obiagu and saying how great of a job he has done this year, and he really has stepped up his game even more than he did last year. Let's throw it over to women's basketball. Over at the Walsh, the women's basketball team has been up and down this last week. They succumbed their first loss of the year to Fordham on Saturday, but did turn it around nicely with a good win over Lehigh on Tuesday. Let's start with the loss to Fordham. What did you guys see from that, or what did you not see from those Pirates?
I'm not going to lie. That one was a tough loss to sit through. I was working haul line for that game, and me and Heaven were just like, what is going on? This team is not playing well. We know they could play better, but they never turned around. They ended up losing, like you said, and the problem with turnovers, I mean, yeah, they gave up a bunch of threes. Haramina had a career game, but 19 turnovers is not going to win you very many basketball games. And then we saw, we're going to talk about it later, but we saw them get better and not have that high number of turnovers in the games moving forward. But it was those turnovers, they were costly. I mean, at halftime, Sydney Cooks had 12 points. She was leading the team in scoring and had 6 turnovers. That is a huge problem. And it's going to be something to look forward to see if Seton Hall can limit those turnovers. But we saw in the next game that they were able to.
I mean, the energy was just off. I was there for Pirate TV with Colleen Smith. And the amount of rebounds, the amount of chances that they just gave back to the Fordham Rams, it just was amazing to see their shortest player, Dingle, at point guard, ripping away rebounds from Sydney Cooks and Katie Armstrong. I mean, it just was not, didn't make any sense for this Pirates team as it's so big. I mean, Andre Espinoza-Hunter standing at 5'11", playing the three. How are they losing the rebound battle? And it's because they were not going in with the same emphasis, the same energy that they need to. And they got blown out on their home court because of it. They're not ready. They just were not ready for seeing a really good Fordham Rams team that gave them their best, honestly.
Yeah, the words that Coach Pazella brought up in his press conference where he was pretty much saying that this team did not come out today mentally tough. They did not come out physically tough. They kind of just were bland. And that was a very disappointing loss because, wow, Fordham, a good team. It's kind of one of those games where it's like, if you win, okay, you won against Fordham. But if you lose, oh, wow, all right, you lost against Fordham. It's one of those areas where you really just want to get those games just so that at the end of the season you're like, okay, but they lost against Fordham. That's an interesting one there. They obviously turned it around against Lehigh, and I'm going to bring that up right now. Just, you know, quick takeaways from that. What did you guys see as they turned it around in that next game on last Tuesday?
Well, like I said, the turnover battle, they definitely did a better job of that, as well as offensively. They had a Laura Park Lane and Espinoza-Hunter had both 20 points, I believe. So that's something that did not happen in the game against Fordham. So both offensively, they were able to do a better job of scoring, and they also lessened the turnovers like I thought they would. I didn't panic when they lost to Fordham, but Coach Pazella was not very – you mentioned it. He was not very happy in the interview after Fordham. So he coached them up. He got them ready to play, and then they went out and played very well.
Yeah, the Stars came out, did a lot better early on. Andre Espinoza-Hunter didn't really score to begin with it at Fordham, but obviously able to fill the cup in that matchup. But also Sydney Cooks able to continue her dominance as well. So that was very good for this Pirates team as they're trying to build.
Christian, you brought up Sydney Cooks. That's someone I kind of want to talk about. As I ask this question, we know what Lauren Park Lane brings to this team. We know what Andre Espinoza-Hunter brings to this team. And they have been kind of carrying this, unlike the men's team, where you have 6, 7 guys that can go on and can they all help out this team score, can all help this team defensively. Women's team, they just don't have that right now. They don't have that depth. What is one player that you would like to see give those two stars some extra help?
I mean, it's a very old team. There's no freshmen on these teams, and they have so many transfers like the Sydney Cooks, but I'm looking at Maya Jackson. It's one of the veterans of this program. And in that Fordham game, she got into early foul trouble, but just could not, not seeing that scoring production that you usually get from Maya Jackson. You can't have a star on your team like that averaging less than 10 points a game. She has to be the one, she has to be a spark plug for this team to make it really go on offense.
Yeah, I agree with you, Maya Jackson. That's a great pick. I'm also really excited to see how she plays because I think she is a star, like you said, and has all the potential in the world. But I'm going to have to look inside at a 6'4 player in Katie Armstrong. We've seen her ability to take over games. She has the potential to score a lot of points in the paint and grab a lot of boards. Now, she kind of has a problem with layups and close-range shots as she seems to miss a lot of those. But regardless, I think Katie Armstrong's potential down low and having a big presence, which is something that Seton Hall kind of lacks, is going to be very, very high. So I think we'll start seeing those shots to fall, those layups to go in the net. And also on the rebounding side, both offensively and defensively, we're going to start to see her get more and more of those. I mean, she averages 7 points and 7 rebounds, so I can't complain too much. Yeah. But nevertheless, I really think that she has a lot of potential to take control down low for this team.
Yeah, of course, it is a relatively new team, just in with all the transfers. So it's only game three. You would like to see things cleaned up. You would like to see the sloppiness come down. You know, there were sometimes even that Lehigh game I was watching, and it was just like back and forth, missed, back and forth, another miss, turnover, turnover. You would like to hope that soon you can kind of get that fixed, and that, and Katie Armstrong is definitely one of those players I would like to see kind of fix that. The Pirates are taking their talents to Cancun. They're going to face a couple teams down there, Iowa being one of them. What are your predictions as the Pirates take their talents there?
Well, these games are not going to be easy by any stretch of the imagination, but based on their most recent game and how they've played, I definitely think they can do some damage. I think we can see this team come out of there with a win or two wins against both Iowa and Toledo, which would be super, super big for the Seton Hall team because kind of like the men's team, like you said, there's a few new players. There's a lot of players who have not played with each other. So getting a big win early is going to help with the chemistry. And also, who knows, it might help for the rankings as far as we're concerned. So putting it on the resume as well as bonding as a team is going to be really helpful going forward. My prediction, my Seton Hall Pirate spirit is very high right now.
You know, we're all in good moods.
I've been winning both of these games, okay? That's what I'm going to say, straight up.
Well, now you're going to make me feel like the bad guy.
Oh, no, you're good, the bad guy,
the passionate. All right, but in talking to Coach Bazell about these matchups, about going to Cancun, he's taking this moment, this Pirates team, let's be honest, they should have made the tournament last year. And they were absolutely devastated that they didn't. And they want to put everyone on notice, but so far through this non-conference play, it has been quite a bit of a struggle. They're not exactly where this team can be, and definitely a surprise for myself because I really thought this team could absolutely start off and run away in non-conference play. But going into Mexico, an Iowa team that is really, really good, number 8 in the country right now, and can be a force nationally, it's going to be hard for me for them to get that win down in Mexico. But, you know, we're rocking with the Pirates.
Yeah, we're rocking with the upsets right now.
I like it. Upsets right now. So, might as well. Let's all go 2-0.
All right.
I love that. I just want to give one more kind of thing as we move on to women's volleyball. It's going to just be quick as their season's almost wrapped up. But, you know, they have 2 games left between Creighton and Providence. Why this season will end without a place in the Big East tournament, they did improve their record massively from previous years. Would you call this season, just one simple question I'll ask you guys, would you call this season a success or a failure?
I think for me, this is definitely a success. For my 4 years at Seton Hall, volleyball was a little bit of a struggle for the Pirates, but in this past season with seeing great veterans having such a good season, I mean, Madison Fruche, Amanda Rockwall, they were absolutely lethal and blocking every single spike that they could. So I'll call it a success.
I would have to agree. I think this is one of the best Seton Hall volleyball teams that we've seen in quite a long time. And also, the young players played well. You mentioned the older players. I'm going to talk about the young players. Perry Lucas and Ilieva, who are both sophomores, both played very, very well. So I think it's a nice building year. I mean, finishing 14-16, 7th in the Big East is not horrible. The Big East is relatively good at volleyball.
Yeah, very good.
Right? So the fact that they were able to improve like so much compared to the previous few years where we know it was not very good at all. I think it's great, and I think these young players will develop and get even better as next year rolls around.
Yeah, I completely agree. I'm going to have to call this season a success as well. Anytime you improve your record like they did this year, I have to go, you know, it's obviously an improving team. It's a rebuilding team, and I like where they're taking this program. Especially over these last 2 losses, they're kind of ending their season well. Nice 2 wins against very good Big East volleyball teams. Before we wrap this one up, Louie, Christian, do you have anything else to say regarding these Seton Hall sports?
Oh, I definitely do have something to say.
Go ahead.
100%. All right, wait for the camera. Go Pirates, whichever one I'm looking at. 3, go Pirates.
Go Pirates. Go Pirates. I mean, I felt it the whole time.
Oh, yeah.
Go Pirates.
We were talking about it all day, right? I was hyped for this episode. Go Pirates.
Well, that's going to do it for this episode of Hall Talk. For my amazing analysts, Louie Pasculli and Christian Gardner, I'm your host, Michael Stamm. It's been a great episode. Go Pirates, and we'll see you next time.